ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕਾ ਖਾਲਸਾ, ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕੀ ਫਤਿਹ।
ਗੁਰੂ ਪਿਆਰੀ ਸਾਧ ਸੰਗਤ ਜੀ, ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕਾ ਖਾਲਸਾ, ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕੀ ਫਤਿਹ। Okay, why are we here today? We have a special present, well, not special, but someone really special. We're going to talk about. Yes? Go ahead. Guru Gobind Singh Ji's birthday. We don't call it birthday, what do we call it? Avtar Purab, right, or Prakash Div. And why do we not call it a birthday? Why do we not call it a birthday?
Because there's no enter, Guruji.
Yeah, excellent. A birthday is a day of birth. So whoever has a birthday has to have a death day. Does Guruji have a death day? No. Where is Guru Gobind Singh Ji right now? Yes, where is he? Right there, right? Granth Sahib Ji. And you know, sometimes you don't feel like if Guruji was sitting there in the human form, we'd probably get affected more, right? We'd see him sitting there all tall and with his dastar and his kalgi and his shastras that he's wearing. And sometimes when we look at Guru Granth Sahib Ji, we don't get that same feeling. But how can you get the same feeling? What is something you could do and it would just be like looking at Guru Gobind Singh Ji? What do you think? Baat, definitely. Simran, yes. Anybody have anything else? Yes? Look at the Panj Pyare, yes. You see the Panj Pyare? Well, I'll tell you one thing that is so powerful, the most powerful thing in this world. And it's a blessing if you can do this, like a true blessing. And that is reading Guru Granth Sahib Ji yourself. So if you sit there and you start reading Guru Granth Sahib Ji from beginning all the way to end, we have a name for it. So when we do it in the Gurdwara Sahib, in 3 days we call it Akhand Paath. But if you were to read it at home on your own, it's called a Sahaj Paath. And you can read a few angs every day, or you can read 10 angs if you can, 20, 30, maybe 5 each day. But you slowly read from beginning to end, and that is so powerful. But there's something you need to have before you can do that. A couple of things. What's the first thing you need to be able to have in order to do that? Yes? Well, that's a quality, but something, a knowledge, an actual knowledgeable thing. Yes? You have to know how to read Gurmukhi. How many of you can read Gurmukhi? Shabash, that's excellent. You should go home and tell your parents that they're awesome parents for making sure that you got to learn Gurmukhi, and you should tell yourselves when you get home that you are awesome for having learned Gurmukhi. And once you learn Gurmukhi, what's the second thing you have to do? Yes. So you learn Paath. So you learn from someone who's called Santhya. And they offer the Gurdwaras so many places. It doesn't matter where you go, but ask your parents to do that for you, and they'll teach you how to read Paath properly, because there is a way to read it. And you know what? You can read Guru Granth Sahib yourself, and that is the greatest thing you can do. Like, this is God's word himself. This is God who created this whole universe. We talk about how big it is, right? Sometimes I show you these pictures of worlds upon worlds upon worlds, and we haven't even seen anything of it. And that God who created all of that, he sent down these very words, right? Jyon Balave Tyo Nanak Das Bole. Guru Nanak Dev Ji says, the way he made me speak, that is how I, his servant, I'm Guru Nanak, the servant of God, that is how I spoke, the way God made me speak. And everything we read in Guru Granth Sahib Ji is God. And isn't it amazing to know what God thinks and what God says? And you can. That's what Guru Granth Sahib Ji is, the word of God. And that is so powerful. So that's something I hope you make a goal in your life. You know, you have these goals. It's a new year, and some people are like, parents are like, I'm going to go to the gym more. You might have little goals for yourself. But you should make a goal in your life as soon as you can. And you don't have to wait till you're 20, 30, or 40 and say, well, I have to wait till I'm old, like my grandpa, my grandma. Even young age like this, I've seen children who are 10 years old, 12 years old, they've taken Santhya already. And they've read all of Guru Granth Sahib Ji. So really lucky that we can do that here in this country. Because when you go to India, I went, remember I told you last year, a couple years ago? And my sister-in-law there, she's even just a few years younger than me, but she doesn't even know how to read Paath properly. And she goes, I really want to learn. She has a Gurkha, but she has no one around where she lives in the village they live in. There's no one there who will teach them how to read Paath properly. So we're really lucky that we have so many places here where we live that we can learn that. Okay, so I want you to remember that in your mind. A really important thing to do. So yes, we're celebrating the Avtar Purva Guru Gobind Singh Ji, And this is a beautiful, beautiful, powerful story, because just like when you go to school, what grade do you start in? Yes? Preschool, right? And then you go all the way up to which grade? Grade 12, right? So that's a lot of years. And everything you're learning, you keep, and then you learn more. And you keep learning more. So in grade 5, does the teacher say, forget everything you learned in kindergarten? No, because you learned how to read and write in read in kindergarten. So you need to remember all that. You keep adding it up, and then finally in grade 12, they say, you are done, and you can graduate. They give you a beautiful certificate. So just like that, the Gurujis came and said, if we tell you everything, it's going to be too much for you. And also, we want to show you. We don't want to just tell you, we want to show you. So Guru Nanak Dev Ji, all the way to Guru Gobind Singh Ji, is 10 gurus, and they all had a really important part to give to you, to give to you that final certificate. And that's when Guru Gobind Singh Ji finally says on Vaisakhi Day that now we are done, and you are all ready, because we have given you the message from the beginning to the end, and to celebrate this day, and to show you how to continue this path. That's what Vaisakhi is all about. So Guru Gobind Singh Ji is really important. He's the last guru who's ever going to come in the human body. After that, our Guruji is going to be Guru Granth Sahib Ji. And whereas before Guruji was tell us his message and speak it, now we can read the message. But it's more powerful than that. And I know when you do Simran, how you feel so strong inside, and you feel the strength, and that is his blessing. And the more Simran you do, the stronger you get, and the more strength you feel. How many of you came this morning to Gurdwara Sahib to listen to the Pog of the Kandapart that they did for Guru Gobind Singh Ji of Dharapur? You came yesterday? How many of you came in the last 3 days? So very, very lucky that you came. And look how nicely the Gurdwara is all done up, decorated, and the white chadra. And so, so special. So who is Guru Gobind Singh Ji's mother? We should all know this. Mata, yes?
Mata Gujari Ji.
He's so excited, he's about to jump up. Yes, Mata Gujari Ji. Yes, that's his mother. And we know Mata Gujari is an extraordinary mother, extraordinary wife, extraordinary grandmother. Every responsibility she was given, she did exactly the way she was supposed to. She didn't, you know, waver from her path. She didn't start doing things that were really weren't very important. She did the right thing. How many of you listen to your parents? And your parents tell you things, respect them. I'm going to tell you one important thing. You have to realize this. If you don't respect your parents, you'll never be able to respect Guru Granth Sahib Ji. It's impossible. You can't say, you know what, I don't respect my mom, and I sometimes yell at her, and sometimes I talk back to her, but oh, I really love Guruji. It's impossible. You can't do that, because your mother and father are Guruji's special teachers that he gave just to you. So he said, I'm really your father, but you have these two people that are going to take care of you, your mom and your dad, and they are the ones that are going to represent a lot of the learning I want to give. So mothers and fathers have a huge responsibility, because they have to make sure all the message that Guruji wants to give to you, that they make sure they get to you. But you have to make sure you always give them respect. Do any of you ever talk back to your mom or dad? Be honest. Sometimes. So you know what? And look, he's being so honest. He's saying, right, sometimes they do. And you know what? We're really going to try not to do that. Because you know what? We're practicing, right? We come here every day. We do Simran. So we get closer to Guruji. And when you don't respect your parents, do you think you can respect Guruji? No, it's really hard. So you have to always, if you get frustrated inside, your parents aren't letting you do something, and you feel this anger is coming, whatever it is that makes you do stuff, you have to say, how would I do if Guruji was standing in front of me? And Guruji was telling me this exact same thing my parents are telling me right now. Would I yell at my Guruji? Would I talk back to my Guruji? No, right? So it's for all of us. I'm an adult person, and I sometimes get frustrated. My mom's older too. I'm lucky. I still have my mom and dad. But you really have to always remember the person I'm talking to. You know, and sometimes we have a hard time controlling our feelings, but you know what? If this is Guruji, would I be like this? And that's what Simran's going to help you do. And when you find it hard and you're like, oh my gosh, I wasn't able to do it, Simran can help you. Remember, I always tell you, what does Simran do? And you always wonder, like, we do Simran, and what does it really do for us? Simran really does help you control all those feelings inside so you behave the way you always should behave. Right? Does everybody understand what I'm saying, right? Okay, so Mata Gujari, the most amazing mother, and all of us want to be, all of us that are women want to be like Mata Gujari. Be strong in our faith, be good daughters of Guru Gobind Singh Ji, be good mothers when we're going to get older, and be really strong, and always, always remember the best thing you can do as a mother is what? The most important thing your mother can do. Who knows? Can we, what's the most important thing a mother can do? Yes? Awesome. Shabash, can you just say that in here?
Put us on the path of Guruji.
You're right. That is the best gift a mother can give you. Okay, so mom's really, really important jobs we have. So, when Mata Gujri, before Shri Guru Gobind Singh Ji, where were they living? Where was the last place that Guru Tegh Bahadur Ji, he established this place? It's a city, it's a beautiful city. It's a city that Guru Gobind Singh Ji has to leave years later. What's that place called? Yes? No, not Chaknaniki. It's a place where, when she's married to Guru Tegh Bahadur Ji, yes? Keskar Sahib, Anandpur Sahib, right? So Anandpur Sahib, they were doing seva there. Have you ever been to Gurdwaras, right? All the Gurdwaras, don't they look like this? People are doing seva. You go to India or you see places, they're cooking outside. So everyone is doing seva. Anandpur Sahib, Mata Gujri is there. Guru Tegh Bahadur Ji is there. And all a lot of Guru Sikhs are there. They're living their lives really in a blessed way. But Guru Tegh Bahadur Ji has an important job. He has to make sure he takes the message of Sikhi to as many people as he can. So he's traveling around and doing prachar, and a lot of times Mata Gujri would go with him. So he'd go to different places and tell people about Sikhi. And so what happens is when he ends up going to a place and he's traveling, he goes to a place called Patna Sahib. Now Patna Sahib is really far from Punjab. I'm going to show you that later. So he traveled and traveled. But when he got there, Mata Gujri was going to have a baby. So she was already about 6 months pregnant. So she's going to have a baby in a few months. So it wasn't safe for her to travel too much. So Mata Gujri stays there in Patna Sahib, and Guru Tegh Bahadur Ji continues traveling to teach the world about Sikhi and God. And he gets all the way over to a place called Assam, which is really far away. Now he knows he's going to have a baby. So does he wait? Does he wait there for his baby? No. Does he say, you know what, I'm going to go and I'll make sure I come back when the baby's born? Does he do that? Why? Does he not love his child? Why would he not do that? Why would he not say, I want to be there when the baby's born? Why? Awesome. He said it's more important to teach other people. He felt it's more important to teach so many more in the world about the message of God. So he was out there traveling and doing this. And now Mata Gujri is going to have a baby. Now this baby is a special baby. Remember to tell you, you're all special souls. Because if you're a human being, it means you did something in some other lifetime that gave you this beautiful blessing. And I've met people, and you know, they'll do part. Two children will start, let's say, at the school at the same time, and they both start to learn part, and one child learns it so quickly, and one child learns it like not so quickly, like in a normal way. And that child who learned it quickly, I know, must have done part in another lifetime before. Because these are special gifts that you have, that you've earned. So if you're a human life, it's a special gift. So Guru Gobind Singh Ji isn't just any person out there. Guru Gobind Singh Ji had a previous life. And he was actually a king, and he was a very religious type of prayer, very spiritual for many, many lifetimes. He's born and died, and he's finally this king. This is the life right before he's going to be born to Mata Gujri. And his name is Dushtadaman, and he was a really powerful king, and he used to always make sure he went and talked to people who talked about God. And people have been talking about God for a long time. When you get older and you go to university, you're going to hear about people like Plato and Socrates. And these are people from many hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years ago, before Jesus Christ even came, before Guru Nanak Dev Ji came. They were always wondering about God, and they knew in their hearts, because Guruji says, Nanak Likhya Nad, which means when you were born, he already put inside a seed that knows that there is a God. And sometimes even when you're sitting on your own, you can remember these things. So he's Dushtadaman, he goes to this place where there's a lot of people talking about religion and God, like really spiritual souls, and they talked about money and how wealth and stuff aren't going to get you closer to God, right? What gets you closer to God is love for God. And they said a lot of people become kings, and they said, but then they get so caught up in their money that they lose all their spiritual power, and then they end up going to a worse place than where they came from. So tap to raj, raj to narak. And when Guruji heard this, he's like, and he was Dushtadaman then, he's like, you know what? I want to get closer to God. and I don't want to get stuck with all this other stuff. So he was one of the richest kings, and he gave all his money away, and he went and did tapasya, which is just meditation, for long, long, long time. Who can tell me that name of the place, which is right here on planet Earth, that he did the Simran on for a long time? You can go visit this place. Many people go there. Yes?
Hemkund Sahib.
Hemkund Sahib. How many of you have heard of Hemkund Sahib? See, you have heard of this place. And that's the place right there. Our Guruji was there. Now, some people don't believe this stuff, right? But it is true. Remember, I told you it's written in Dasma Granth. And who put all Dasma Granth together for Guru Gobind Singh Ji and left it for us? Who was that? It was in him. It's by Mani Singh, remember? So we know that these are really, really important writings of Guru Gobind Singh Ji. And he talked a lot about his previous life. And one day we'll talk to you about that. But today I want to tell you another, quickly tell you about his birth. So Guru Gobind Singh Ji is born in Patna Sahib. How many of you have been there? So there's five really important places of the Sikh religion. Really five important places. They're called our Panj Takht. And everybody in our lifetime, we should try to visit those places. And so a couple of years ago, when I went to India, I was really, really lucky. And I got a chance with my family to go to Patna Sahib. And this is where Guru Gobind Singh Ji's Avtarpurb happened in 1666. Why did it happen there? Because a lot of our gurus are born in Punjab or old Punjab that's in Pakistan now. They're all born in that area. Guru Gobind Singh Ji is the only one born so far away. Does anybody know why? We know Mata Guruji is traveling and she's left there. But why would that place be special? Yes. Okay, so he said they were traveling. They had to leave the place where most of the gurus were born. That's what happened in this lifetime. But let me tell you what's so special about that place. When Guru Nanak Dev Ji was here, he actually went to that place in Patna Sahib. And there was a really amazing person there who was like a Sikh. He's going to become a Sikh later. His name is Salas Rai Jordi. And he loved Guru Nanak Dev Ji and spent a lot of time doing seva of him. And when it's time for Guru Nanak Dev Ji to leave, he got really sad. He goes, Guru Nanak Dev Ji, I want you to stay here. I want you to stay in my house. Guru Nanak Dev Ji said, I can't stay in your house, because I have to tell so many other people about God and Sikhi. But you know what? I will make you this promise. When I come back in my 10th form, so the 10th time I come back, which is going to be as Guru Gobind Singh Ji, he goes, I'll be this brave, brave warrior, and this is the house in which I will come back to this world, and I'll make you that promise. And Salas Rai was so happy, and that's exactly what happened. And that's why, even though Guru Tegh Bahadur is traveling, and he had to leave Mata Guruji in Patna Sahib, that was why it was meant to happen, because they had to fulfill the promise that Guru Nanak Dev Ji had made to Salas Rai. So Gobind Singh Ji is actually, his birth, when he comes to this world, it's in his house, where Salas Rai's house was, where Guru Nanak Dev Ji stayed before that. So he comes to this world, and this is the well. When you go to Patna Sahib, they have a special well there, and that's the same well that Mata Guruji was right beside when she was giving birth to Guru Gobind Singh Ji. So it's really special, right? Because that is the spot where Guru Gobind Singh Ji is born. So at the same time, what happens is there's a Muslim, not a Sikh, not a Hindu, a Muslim, Pir Pikhan Shah, and he is doing his prayers. And Muslims always pray to which place? And he's in a place called Kurum. That's his village, a small little village that he's from in Punjab. But he's bowing and praying to this place. What is this place? It's really special for Muslims. What is it called? It starts with an M. Yeah, what is it called?
Mosque.
It is a type of mosque, but it's the most holiest. What is it called? Somebody said it over here. Somebody know? Yes? Makkah, right? And that's where they pray to. And they always bow down. So they do their prayers five times a day. And I've seen people even in Guildford Mall do this. I was at downtown once in Pacific Center. And they're so pakke that when they do their part, I've been to stores before that are owned by Muslims that practice their religion really properly, and they don't care what time it is. They set out their mat and they sit down. They do the prayers five times a day, and they will always bow down to the direction of Mecca, which is to the west. So do you see those two arrows? So the arrow on the left is pointing towards Saudi Arabia, which is where Mecca is, and on the right-hand side is pointing towards Patna Sahib. So right in the middle, where those two the ends of the arrows connect, is where Pir Pikhan Shah is. So he's supposed to be bowing to the west, which is to the left side, right? But the day Guru Gobind Singh Ji comes to this world, all his followers are sitting there because he's a really powerful saint. And all the people who respect him are sitting there in Sangat. Just like when we come here, there's sometimes a speaker who comes from India and he's really, really knowledgeable and we have so much respect for him. We all come, we want to listen to his gatha. So a lot of people respected B.P. Kincha like that. And they all came and sat down and listened to him. And they're all bowing to the West because that's Muslims all have to always bow to the West. But this day, he bowed to the East and his followers got shocked. Just like we would. If somebody came in here with their shoes on and they were like a granthi, would you be shocked? Because you think you should know better. You're the granthi. You're the person who tells us what to do. What are you doing? So his followers got really upset. And he said, listen, we're here in Punjab. See that red arrow? That's where Patna Sahib is, in the state of Bihar in India. It takes a long time. When I went a couple of years ago there, I had to fly in a plane. It's so far away. And so he said, it's actually 1,200 kilometers away from Punjab. So he said, guess what? Allah, who you're praying to, he's come to this world. Allah has come here. And you know, some of his followers got so bad at him, they just walked out. But some of them really respected him. And they said, if you believe that, then it must be true. He goes, yes. Allah is born to speak in Shah, right? Was he right? Yes. So that means he's a very strong spiritual soul. He knew Guru Gobind Singh Ji had come to the world. So he said, sat down, he said, I have a chance in this lifetime of mine to see God as a human being. And I want to go see him. I get to see a person who's such a prophet, a high spiritual soul, I'll get to see him in this lifetime. And I want to do that. So he decided to walk there. Now how many kilometers is it? Almost like 1,200 kilometers away. It's going to take, he's going to walk every day 30 kilometers. You know how far 30 kilometers? It's like farther than Abbotsford. It's like walking from here all the way to Abbotsford. And they're going to sleep, waking up and doing it again. And again, and again. And how many days did he have to do that for? 40 days. That's more than a month. I'm telling you right now, like, if I walked 30 kilometers, I would be, like, wouldn't be able to walk again for a week because you get so tired. One day, my friend and I, we were walking, and we walked 10 kilometers, and we were really, really tired the next day. So 30 kilometers is a long way to do it day after day after day after day. And he did that, and guess what? He did it barefoot. Why would he do it barefoot? Respect. Just like we come to Gurdwara Sahib, respect, right? We're showing Satkar of Guruji, right? And respect for the body that's in here, right? Respect for all the Sangat that's in here. So he walked barefoot all the way from his village, Kuram, all the way down to Patna Sahib, where Guru Gobind Singh Ji is. Look, and that's on a map to show you how far he had to walk. And it wasn't like today he could take, you know, a train or he just walked barefoot the whole way. He didn't take horses, he didn't take cars or have a plane. He walked. And Guru Gobind Singh Ji is there. But when he gets there and he asks to see Guru Gobind Singh Ji, Guru Gobind Singh Ji's Mama Ji, who's Mata Guji's brother, Kripal Chand, he says, you can't come in. And there's many reasons. Because first of all, the baby was just a few months old. Second of all, Guru Tegh Bahadur Ji hadn't even seen his son. Plus, they knew a lot of people were out there who might want to try to kill Guru Gobind Singh Ji. Because they're like, Guru Tegh Bahadur Ji is a baby right now, right? Because we know later, right, as Guru Ji gets older, all the Mughals are going to try to... Remember, Guru Tegh Bahadur Ji gives a shahidi and all the stuff's going on. So there's a lot of reasons that they said you can't see the baby yet. So B.P. Kincha, when they said that, he started to cry. He said, you have to let me see this baby. And then Mata Guji felt bad for him. She said, listen, she goes, ask for anything else, I'll give it to you. Anything you want. This is the house of Guru Baba Nanak. You can have anything you want. I just can't give you that one thing. You can't see the baby. And then B.P. Kincha said, that's fine. You give me something that is equal to me seeing Allah in the human form. And Mata Gujari knew. There's nothing in the world. She knew the only thing she could give him is darshan of Guru Gobind Singh Ji. But she said, you know, Peer Ji, I can't. So he sat out there. He did a chonkra. And he sat. And he just started meditating, praying to God, to Allah, like, please, I want to do your darshan. I'm here. And what happened? Mata Gujari saw his love for Guruji. She saw that how much he wanted to. So then she came out Because Mataji was a beautiful, wonderful lady with a lot of love, a lot of daya, but a very strong woman too. Very strong and courageous. So she came out and she brought it above, and she said, it is a tradition that we do kirtan to get blessings, right? Every time you come to Gurdwara Sahib, there's always kirtan happening, right? Before we do katha, we always have kirtan playing, right? Kirtan is the supreme. Remember we heard that last time in Kaljug? Kaljug mein kirtan pradana. It's the most important thing because it makes your heart soft when you listen to music, the word of God with music playing. It's done in a rag, right? 31 different ways of playing that music in Guru Granth Sahib Ji. And we listen to it, it softens our heart. Then you hear the katha, and you know what? It touches your heart more. So this is what happened. So Mata Gujari said, we're going to do kirtan first. And then she said, now you can come and do darshan. So Peer Beacon Shah came in, and he saw, the first thing he did when he saw Guruji, and he is a old saint who's got so many people who follow him, but he that day looked at that little baby, and we think babies are like smaller than us, like we're smarter than babies, we're older than babies, we're everything more than a baby. But he knew what this baby really was. So he got on his knees and he kissed Guruji's charan first, his feet. He kissed them, he put it on his forehead. Then he said, I have one question. I want to know that in this life, in this world, which religion are you going to respect more? The Hindu or the Muslim religion? So he asked the question in his mind, and he said, if you truly are God, you'll know my question. Then he said, can I have two pots? So he put milk in one pot, and he said to Guruji, this is to represent the Hindu religion. He put water in the other pot. He said, this is for the Muslim religion. And then he knelt on his knees, and he put the pots in front of Guruji, and he said, whichever pot that you touch, I'll know in my mind, because I know you can hear what my mind is thinking right now, because you are antarjami, you know everything. And then he said, then you will know, I will know. And what did Guruji do? Guruji put his hands, and he was like a baby, like just splashing his hands around, like little babies, they don't control their hands. But with a lot of control, he put his hands on both pots, and Peer Beacon Shah felt the whole weight of the universe on those pots. He couldn't even hold them anymore. The baby's strength was so much, it pushed both those pots down, and he felt the whole universe was coming down on his hands. So he had to let go of the pots, and they both broke and crashed all over the floor. But he knew, and he smiled. He said, you have told me the answer to my question. What is the answer to his question? What is the answer?
Respect all religions.
You will respect all religions. You know, so many prophets have come into this world, but our Gurujis are the only ones where all the Hindus, the Muslims, everyone of all religions love them. The people who are able to recognize what God is, and they recognize Guruji for what he was. And he told the whole world that I will always recognize all the human races one. Manas ki jaat sabe ekke pachanabo. He goes, recognize that all of the human race were all created by God. So I'm going to stop here quickly because Bikramji Paji has a katha to tell you today too, and so I don't want to take too much time. But I want you to remember this, how important it is. And we're so lucky, we're part of the religion that Guru Gobind Singh Ji chose to practice himself. So he said, Hindu's good, Muslim's good, but you know the religion I'm going to practice is Sikhism. And you know what? We're so blessed, so we want to make sure we're doing all of those things to get closer to Guruji. Now put your hands together, and you're going to say that, Fateh, that Guru Gobind Singh Ji blessed us with, right, that he gave to us. Vaheguru Ji ka Khalsa, Vaheguru Ji ki Fateh.
Together, let's say Fateh first. Let's read a little Bani, because Guru Granth says Bani softened our hearts. Hum avgun pare ek gun nahi, amrit shad dikhay bikkai, maya moh param kai bhule, sut dara siyon preet lagai. ਇੱਕ ਉੱਤਮ ਪੰਥ ਸੁਣਿਓ ਗੁਰ ਸੰਗਤ ਤੇ ਮਨੰਤ ਜਮਤ ਰਾਸ ਮਟਾਈ ਇੱਕ ਅਰਦਾਸ ਪਾਠ ਕੀਰਤ ਕੀ ਗੁਰੂ ਰਾਮਦਾਸ ਰਾਖੋ ਸਰਨਾਈ ਇੱਕ ਅਰਦਾਸ ਪਾਠ ਕੀਰਤ ਕੀ ਗੁਰੂ ਰਾਮਦਾਸ ਰਾਖੋ ਸਰਨਾਈ ਮਿੱਤਰ ਪਿਆਰੇ ਨੂੰ ਤੁਧ ਬਿਨ ਰੋਗ ਰਜਾਈਆਂ ਦਾ ਯੋਟਣ ਨਾਗ ਨਿਵਾਸਾਂ ਦੇ ਰਹਿਣਾ ਸੂਲ ਸੁਰਾਹੀ ਖੰਜਰ ਪਿਆਲਾ ਬਿੰਗ ਕਸਾਈਆਂ ਦਾ ਸਹਿਣਾ ਯਾਰੜੇ ਦਾ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਸੱਥਰ ਚੰਗਾ ਪੱਠ ਖੇੜਿਆਂ ਦਾ ਰਹਿਣਾ ਨਿੰਡੌਤ ਬੰਧਨ ਅਨਕ ਵਾਰ ਸਰਬ ਕਲਾ ਸਮਰੱਥ ਡੋਲਣ ਤੇਰਾ ਖੋ ਪ੍ਰਭੂ ਨਾਨਕ ਦੇ ਕਰ ਹੱਥ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕਾ ਖਾਲਸਾ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕੀ ਫਤਿਹ ਸੋ ਭੈਣ ਜੀ ਟੋਲਡ ਯੂ ਗਾਈਸ ਅਬਾਊਟ ਹੂ ਟੁਡੇ ਵਾਂਟਸ ਮੀ ਟੂ ਨੋ
ਗੋਬਿੰਦ ਸਿੰਘ ਜੀ
ਗੁਰੂ ਗੋਬਿੰਦ ਸਿੰਘ ਜੀ ਐਂਡ ਹੂ ਇਜ਼ ਗੁਰੂ ਗੋਬਿੰਦ ਸਿੰਘ ਜੀ ਟੂ ਅਸ
ਆਵਰ 10th ਗੁਰੂ
ਆਵਰ 10th ਗੁਰੂ ਵਾਟ ਐਲਸ ਇਜ਼ ਹੀ Our Father, everybody agree? He's our Father. And when you take Amrit, the day you get ready to take Amrit, that's what they're going to tell you, the Panch Pyares, that your father is Guru Gobind Singh Ji and your mother is? Who's your mother? Who knows? Mata Sahib Kaur. Does everybody agree? So, father is Guru Gobind Singh Ji and mother is Mata? Alright, and what is your village? They tell you, the Panch Pyares. What is the village? From now on your village, not from Dwaba, na Malwa, na Majja, right? But your village, where are you from? What village are you from?
Anandpur Sahib.
Anandpur Sahib. And your house is? Your house is? What is it? No, who has it right? Oh, somebody has it right here.
Kesgarh
Sahib. Yes. So now we know our house, we know our village, we know our mother, and we know our father. Now we are all, if our mother is the same, our father is the same, our house is the same, our village is the same, then what are we? What are we? Again, see, you got to use the word over here. Somebody got to get a new person.
Six.
We are six, yes, but something even closer than that.
Siblings.
We are siblings, good. We are family. So we are a family. And you know what? That's what we all have to understand. Isn't it beautiful to have a big family like this? And having a father like Guru Gobind Singh Ji and Panji told you that we can't talk about, there's no words to explain Guru Gobind Singh Ji, what he has done. And there's not going to be anybody like him. There's not everybody who before was like him or anybody who's going to be like him in the future. Nobody. And there's so many stories we can tell about Guru Gobind Singh Ji and all the things that he done. He was called Bala Pritam when he was young. And I mean, Mataji gave him that gold bracelet and he took it. And you know what? He threw it in the river. And then Mataji asked him, where'd the gold bracelet go? He had the other one on his hand. He threw it over also. He said, oh, it went over there. And I mean, that's how much he cared about the money and wealth. I mean, that's how we have to understand, not just that. And when we do go here and you can see people Matha taking here, they're taking Guru Granth Sahib Ji. And Guru Nanak Dev Ji, the same, remember the same light from Guru Nanak Dev Ji to Guru Gobind Singh Ji, and today residing in Guru Granth Sahib Ji, right here, all 10 Gurus, Hajar Najar, right here when Matha taking. And when we put money in, sometimes we think, why put $5 in? Why put $10 in? Somebody said that I gave $2,000 or $3,000 to the Gurdwara Sahib. No. That's the wrong way of thinking. What can we give? What can we give to Guru? Nothing. That's why always when you come into the feet of Guru Granth Sahib Ji, always say these few words. Always, ye jur kehna, mera mujhme kish nahi. Nothing. Jo aviya, this is not mine. Mera mujhme kish nahi. Jo kish hai, so tera. Everything that is of yours, thoda. Tera tujhko saunpte. After giving what it is yours, and you're giving me the strength to put it back in your golak and in your feet again. Tera tujhko saunpte. Kya lage mere? When it was already yours, and who am I to claim that this is mine? And that's where the ego goes away. But if I show that I have $5 or $10 and I show people I'm putting it over here, what comes? The ego. Remember? The ego. And remember? Homme nave naal virodh hai, doe na basai ek thai. Wherever there's ego, there will be no God. Or blessing of Guru or God. Guru Maharaj teaches so many things. You're going to give and give without letting anybody know. When you give without anybody letting anybody know, that's what's going to come up in many folds and going to go out there and grow in many folds. Remember the seed that grows? If you put the seed in the ground, that's the seed that's going to grow. But if a seed stays up on top of the ground, is that going to grow? No. The seed that goes in the ground is the seed that's going to grow. And the same thing goes for if you're doing Simran and Bani and your pot. It's not just Maya, money or anything. Anything. If you're doing pot and you do a lot of pot and you say, I get up Amartavilla every day. I do 5 malas. I do 5 sukhani saade pot. I do this. You're saying all these things. Guess what's come? Why are you saying these things? Because of your, I can't hear you, louder, ego. Can you see that? Doesn't matter. You're at school. Somebody can't afford a $100 shoes or $100 shirt or $100 jacket, but you can. You're wearing it and you're flashing it. What is it? I can't hear you. What is it? Ego. Ego is dangerous. And that's the wall between us and God. Could be anything. If you're stronger than somebody, then you're pushing somebody around. The same thing. What is it? Ego. Every little thing. Could be anything. Little things. So it's so tiny that it's not so to the brick, like a wing of a machar, of a mosquito. That's how thin and thin it is. And the path is so narrow too. This path is so narrow. So little things can keep us off the path. And a lot of times, we told you guys before, a lot of times people ask, oh, when we come to the Gurdwara Sahib, oh, some people seem like they get blessed. And you know what? They don't worry about nothing. They don't worry about anything. In Guru Gobind Singh's time, all our gurus' time, even today, you can see what's happening. Are there some bad people in the world? We hear on the news all the time, are there some bad people in the world today? Can you hear? Just people dying the other day. This lady, 53-year-old lady, just died because somebody just killed her because they weren't trying to purse away. So is there some bad people today? I can't hear you guys. Are there some bad people today? Yes. Were there some bad people then when Guru's times happened or even before them? But everybody is born a small little baby. Do their parents want them to be like that? They don't want them to be like that. What makes them go in that direction? What makes them go in that direction? Who wants to tell me?
Not by following the true path.
Yeah, not by following the true path.
Ego.
Ego, absolutely.
Bad sangat.
Bad sangat. Do we agree? All these things, we all agree?
Money.
Money, if you have too much money,
right? What happens is sometimes make your head go away. Sometimes that happens too. Yeah.
Video games.
Video games, yeah, yeah. Depending on what kind you play too.
Bad friends.
Bad friends, the sangat, right? Bad sangat.
TV.
Too much TV and bad TV.
Not really caring about anything else except what you want.
Yeah, just being so greedy and just thinking that, oh, whatever I think is right, right? And not listening to anybody.
Bad words.
So there's a lot of things. When we went to this at the camp too, there's a lot of things that you guys had.
Not respecting our parents.
Yeah, so all this comes. So not respecting your parents. We'll tell you two more. Okay, one more.
Not respecting God.
Not respecting God.
Swearing.
Swearing. Oh my God. So that would make a person really bad.
Watching violence.
Violence. Watching violence on TV. One more. Last one. Okay, this one. Last one.
Alcohol.
Alcohol. Jit piti mazdoor hoye varl pave vich aaye apna paraya na pehchane khasmo takke khaye. Absolutely. All these things. It's going to make somebody a bad person. And does any parent want their child to be bad? Nobody. I was just thinking about it myself too. I was thinking, you know what? We're going through this world. More people I read it on somebody's car. More people I know. More I love my pet or my dog or cat, right on the back. More people I know, more I love my cat or dog. Because what happens is you're knowing more people and you're getting in more and more situations. And sometimes you just want to find that peace. Because you want to find that oneness. You're looking for that oneness in yourself. We just can't find it sometimes. You want to get, remember those gangs? They say if you get into a gang, you can't get out. Right? If you get into a gang, you can't get out. But they won't let you out. And that's why you got to stay away from that sangat. And Guru Maharaj tells us everything. He goes about the bad sangat and stuff. He tells us, Sakat sangna kijiye, duro jaiye paaj. Just run away. If you see some bad sangat, then take off, run away. But I'm going to tell you a little small little story. But I think I shared it with you guys before too. I just want to share it again today. Because apa kebari sangat honne assi kehne kaiyan de mann chat guru de naal jud jande aa mardi bakhsh, and you can see unna de vich shanti bhi unna ko baitha bhi thanu unna guru di gal karni, they're going to talk about good things, they're going to talk about anna ki bani aur kinna nitnem kida chalda bani kida chaldi aa parivar kida bani vich, they're going to talk about these kind of things. Kaiyan ko jaoge utthe ji karde dab dab daud gaye itthon, or you feel after you sat down there, you feel empty. And you feel, oh my God, I wasted so much of my time. It's like, apa kehnde ki paani ridkde aa, right? When we go out there, we're blending water, and everything comes out. But if you blend milk, then makhan ta nikle aunda, right? So, we're going out there blending water, there's nothing comes out. So that's what happens sometimes when you're spending time with those kind of people. That's why Mara tells us to do some good sangat. Because with the good sangat, all the TV is good sangat, good friends are good sangat, right? Listening to Gurbani is good sangat. All the sangat that you're doing, you know what that's going to do? This mind, remember? Man mela, sab kish mela. And then Guru Maharaj, you see in Javi, man jite, jag jeet. You win the mind, you win everything. Your mind is filthy, everything is filthy. Everything is filthy. So you know what? So all this stuff we have to do to make this mind. So Guru Maharaj, one time they're in the darbar. Darbar se baithe Maharaj. In Guru Sikha ne ye sawal puchhiya, Maharaj, some people come into your charan, thode charan ch aunde aa. Oh aunde aa, unnu te inni kirpa ho jandi, unnu ne tusi pyar karde aa, unnu inna nede lyaunde aa. So kai thade ko 25-25 30 saal to hi seva karde, oh thade nede nahi, thade wala pyar vi lai sake. Unna de utte chehreyan te vi utte ko rang ko jalal nahi dis reha. Unde ko chehre te khushi nahi dis rahi. Unna de fikr te oh stress te kami oh dis rahi aa. Why? Guru Maharaj kehnde, idda karo, bring a bucket of water. Brought a bucket of water. Kehnde idda karo, ich patthar pa deo. Lya ke paani di balti bhari, patthar paata. Kehnde idda karo, liao patase pa deo. Put patase in there. Chalo utthe pya rehn ditti balti for a while. Darbar samapat hoya te kehnde hun thoda sawal da jawab denne. I'll give you an answer now. He goes, now go bring the bucket. Bucket lyandi. Kehnde patthar kaddo. Patthar kad liya. Kehnde liao patase kaddo. Kehnde Maharaj, patase ta chal gaye. Patase na rehnde. Patase kithe gaye? Kolm lag gaye paani vich. Patthar ਉਦਾਂ ਦਾ ਉਦਾਂ ਹੀ ਰਿਹਾ ਉਹ ਸਾਡੇ ਪੱਥਰ ਮਨ ਪੱਥਰ ਹਿਰਦੇ ਉਦਾਂ ਹੀ ਰਹਿੰਦੇ ਆ When we come here, ਅਸੀਂ ਆਪਣਾ ego ਨਹੀਂ ਛੱਡਦੇ. We don't let our ego go. ਅਸੀਂ ਆਪਣਾ ਆਪ ਸਮਰਪਿਤ ਨਹੀਂ ਕਰਦੇ ਗੁਰੂ ਨੂੰ. ਅਸੀਂ ਗੁਰੂ ਦੀ ਮੱਤ ਨਹੀਂ ਲੈਂਦੇ. ਆਪਣੀ ਮੱਤ ਅਸੀਂ ਨਾਲ ਹੀ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਆਉਂਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਅਤੇ ਨਾਲ ਹੀ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਚੱਲ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਹਾਂ. We don't let our own mind go. ਅਸੀਂ ਸਮਰਪਿਤ ਹੋਈਏ. And when you do that, ਫਿਰ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਜਾ ਤੂੰ ਮੇਰਾ ਹੋ ਰਹੇ ਹੋ ਸਭ ਜਗ ਤੇਰਾ ਹੋਏ. You become mine, everything becomes yours. You come here, leave this mind. ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਮਾਰਨਾ ਚਾਹੁੰਦੇ ਛੱਡ ਕੇ ਜਾਈਏ. With faith, ਭਰੋਸਾ, ਵਿਸ਼ਵਾਸ. We have to have the faith. When nothing, all, everything fails, ਅਸੀਂ ਕਈ ਵਾਰੀ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਆਹ ਬੁਲਾਣ ਨਾ ਜਾਣਦਾ, ਮੈਨੂੰ ਆਹ ਬੰਦਾ ਜਾਣਦਾ, ਆਹ ਬੰਦਾ ਜਾਣਦਾ, ਮੈਨੂੰ ਇਹਦਾ ਆਸਰਾ, ਮੈਨੂੰ ਇਹਦਾ ਆਸਰਾ. ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਗੁਰੂ ਗੋਬਿੰਦ ਸਿੰਘ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਕਿਸੇ ਦਾ ਆਸਰਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਸੀਗਾ, ਮੈਨੂੰ ਉਹਦਾ ਇੱਕ ਦਾ ਆਸਰਾ ਸੀ. ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਬਾਣੀ 'ਚ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਗੁਰੂ ਅਰਜਨ ਦੇਵ ਪਾਤਸ਼ਾਹ ਮਾਨੋ ਕੀ ਟੇਕ ਬਿਰਥੀ ਸਭ ਜਾਨ ਦੇਵਨ ਕੋ ਏਕੇ ਭਗਵਾਨ ਦਾ ਇੱਕ ਦਾ ਆਸਰਾ ਰੱਖੋ. ਓਨਲੀ ਵਨ. If you keep the faith in that one, in Guru Maharaj, everything is yours. That's what always when you come to the feet, Guru Maharaj, have that faith. And those people, unna de andar pyar. Kyunki jede gaala kadde, jede banda gaala hi kadda, jede muh te gaal nikal jayi hai, nikaldi hai, mare naan ek fikka hai boliye, tan man fikka hoye, sareer bhi, man bhi, tan man fikka hoye, fikko fikka sadiye, fikke fikke soye, fikka murakh aakhiye. ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਫਿੱਕੇ ਨੂੰ ਮੂਰਖ, ਫੂਲਸ, ਕ੍ਰੇਜ਼ੀ. ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਜਿੱਦਾਂ ਨੇ ਦਿਸ ਗੁਰਬਾਣੀ ਇਸ ਸਿੰਘ ਫਿੱਕਾ ਮੂਰਖ ਆਖੀਏ ਭਾਣਾ ਲੈ ਸਜਾਏ. ਭਾਣਾ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਜੁੱਤੀਆਂ ਦੀ, ਜੁੱਤੀਆਂ ਦੀ ਮਾਰ ਪੈਂਦੀ ਆ ਇੱਥੇ ਵੀ ਉਹਨਾਂ 'ਤੇ ਪੈਂਦੀ ਆ ਅਤੇ ਗਾਂ ਵੀ ਪੈਂਦੀ ਆ. ਈਹਾਂ ਖਾਟ ਚਲੋ ਹਰਲਾਹਾ ਆ ਗਏ ਵਸਣ ਸੁਹੇਲਾ. ਉਹਨਾਂ ਤਾਂ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਇੱਥੇ ਨਾਮ ਚੱਪ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਇੱਥੇ ਵੀ ਸੁਹੇਲਾ, ਗਾਂ ਵੀ ਸੁਹੇਲਾ. ਪਰ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਆਹ ਕੰਮ ਕਰ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਆ ਉਹ ਫਿਰ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਪਾਪੀ ਕਰਮ ਕਮਾਮਦੇ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਾਏ ਹਾਏ ਨਾਨਕ ਜਿਉਂ ਮੱਥਣ ਮਧਾਣੀਆਂ ਤੇ ਉਹ ਮੱਥੇ ਧਰਮ ਰਾਏ. ਇੱਥੇ ਵੀ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਕੜ ਕੜ ਕੇ ਮਰ ਜਾਣਾ ਤੇ ਗਾਂ ਜਾਵੇਗੀ, ਉਹੀ ਹਾਲ ਹੋਣਾ. ਸੋ ਆਲਵੇਜ਼ ਹੈਵ ਫੇਥ, ਹੈਵ ਫੇਥ ਇਨ ਯੂਰ ਗੁਰੂ. ਆਲਵੇਜ਼ ਡੂ ਵਟ 5 minutes ਆ, ਹਾਊ ਮੈਨੀ ਮਿੰਟਸ ਆਫ ਸਰਵਿੰਗ, ਹਾਊ ਮੈਨੀ, ਐਵਰੀ ਨਾਟ ਸਮ ਟਾਈਮਸ ਰਾਈਟ ਐਵਰੀ ਡੇ. ਉਹ ਥੋੜ੍ਹੇ ਜਿਹੇ 5 ਮਿੰਟ ਸਿਮਰਨ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚੋਂ ਉਹ 'ਚੋਂ ਬਰਕਤ ਸ਼ੁਰੂ ਹੋ ਜਾਣੀ ਆ ਆਪਣੇ ਆਪ, ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਰੰਗ ਲਾਗਤ 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 ਹੈ, ਪਰਮ ਭਉ ਭਾਗਤ 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 ਹੈ, ਜਨਮ ਜਨਮ ਕਾ ਸੋਇਆ ਇਹ ਮਨ ਜਾਗਤ 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 ਹੈ. ਦਿਸ ਮਾਈਂਡ ਦੈਟ ਹੈਜ਼ ਬੀਨ ਫਿਲਡ ਵਿਦ ਆਲ ਦਿਸ ਫਿਲਥ ਫਰ ਜਨਮਸ ਇਟਸ ਗੋਇੰਗ ਟੂ ਗੈਟ ਵਾਸ਼ਡ ਵਿਦ ਵਾਟ? ਮਨ ਧੋਵੋ ਸ਼ਬਦ ਲਾਗੋ, ਬਾਈ ਸ਼ਬਦ, ਬਾਈ ਬਾਣੀ, ਬਾਈ ਗੁੱਡ ਸੰਗਤ, ਬਾਈ ਗੁੱਡ ਡੀਡਸ. ਐਵਰੀ ਡੇ ਟ੍ਰਾਈ ਟੂ ਵਾਸ਼ ਇਟ, ਐਂਡ ਵਨ ਡੇ ਇਟਸ ਗੋਇੰਗ ਕਮ ਟੂ ਬੀ ਆਲ ਪਿਓਰ. And you're going to be one with God. One. And then all that strength and power is going to come. All right? So have that faith. And you guys are so lucky. We are all so lucky that we get to spend this time in the Sangat together. And every Sunday, what time do we got to be here every Sunday? I can't hear you. What time? 6 o'clock Sunday. So we're going to be 40 mukti. We're going to start our Simran 14th. But Sunday darbar is going to be this way. So make sure that you guys come here. And we'll do sermon in that part too. I was going to do sermon, but I just ran out of time right now. But make sure you do your sermon when you get home. So I got to really stop right now because our time is up. But make sure, how many minutes of sermon every day? 5 minutes of sermon. Okay? So we're going to do the draw really quickly. So I'm going to pull out the tickets. Here we go. Where's the number? All right. 7-5-3-3-7-7 7-5-3-3-7-7. Do we have a winner? Going once, going twice, and all right, next one. 7-5-3-3-7-3 7-5-3-3-7-3 going once, going twice, and where do they all go? All right, another one, last one. Here we go. 7-5-3-3-7-2 Do we have a winner? Yes. And what's the magic question? Well, let's see your number first. Yep. Magic question, 5 minutes of?
Yes.
Well, good job, excellent. See, that makes you feel good. Okay, you want to, we got 2 prizes actually today. Okay, there you go. All right, before the second prize, we're going to do what? I know you're going to take off after you do the second prize, right? So okay, they got it because jo bole so nihal. Jeda bhi boluga oh ho jau nihal. Right? Remember apa pichle puchya si ke bole so nihal da matlab ki ya. So next week apa puchhange tar tumhu yaad hai ki nahi? All right? So jo bole so nihal. ਅੱਜ ਜਿਹਨੇ ਵੀ ਨਿਹਾਲ ਹੋਣਾ ਬਾਹਾਂ ਖੜੀਆਂ ਕਰਕੇ ਜਕਾਰਾ ਛੱਡਣਾ ਸਾਰਿਆਂ ਨੇ ਮੰਮੀ ਜੀ ਡੈਡੀ ਜੀ ਗ੍ਰੈਂਮਾ ਗ੍ਰੈਂਪਾ ਸਾਰੇ ਹਾਜ਼ਰੀਆਂ ਲਵਾ ਲਓ ਦੇਖ 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 ਪੰਥ ਕੀ ਰਾਜ ਕਰੇਗਾ ਜੀ ਰਾਜ ਕਰੇਗਾ ਚੂਲ ਤੇ ਨਿਸ਼ਾਨ ਰਹੇ ਚੂਲ ਤੇ ਨਿਸ਼ਾਨ ਰਹੇ ਬੋਲੇ ਸੋ ਨਿਹਾਲ ਬੋਲੇ ਸੋ ਨਿਹਾਲ बोले सो निहाल एंड ऑल्सो वी हैव टू से टुडे मेक श्योर तन है तन है तन है गुरु गोबिंद सिंह जी तन है तन है तन है तन है गुरु गोबिंद सिंह जी तन है तन है तन है तन है गुरु ग्रंथ साहिब जी तन है तन है तन है तन है गुरु साध संगत जी तन है तन है तन है तन है तेरा पंथ खालसा तन है सत नाम श्री वाहिगुरु बोल सत नाम श्री वाहिगुरु बोल वाहिगुरु बोल कदी ना डोल वाहिगुरु बोल कदी ना डोल बोले सो निहाल
753299 going once, going twice, and gone. You gotta quickly do it. You have it? I got it. Aja, aja. Good job. Look at two, three, four. You have to put love that you get. All right. Okay. Here we go. ਜਕਾਰਾ
ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕਾ ਖਾਲਸਾ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ
ਜੀ ਜਕਾਰਾ
ਬੋਲੇ ਸੋ ਨਿਹਾਲ
ਸਤਿ ਸ੍ਰੀ ਅਕਾਲ 5 ਮਿੰਟ ਸਿਮਰਨ
ਯੈਸ
ਗੁੱਡ ਜੋਬ ਸੀ ਇਹ ਬੱਚੇ ਸਿਮਰਨ ਕਰਦੇ ਆ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਧੰਨ ਨੇ ਤਨਾਂ ਦੀਆਂ ਮਾਵਾਂ ਜਿਨ੍ਹਾਂ ਦੇ ਬੱਚੇ ਨਾਮ ਜਪਦੇ ਬਾਬਾ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਅਤਰ ਸਿੰਘ ਹੋਣੀ ਮਸਤ ਬਣ ਵਾਲੇ ਅਤੇ ਆਈ ਮੀਨ ਦੀਜ਼ ਆਰ ਬਿਊਟੀਫੁਲ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਬੱਚੇ ਨਾਮ ਜਪਦੇ ਆ ਧੰਨ ਨੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਮਾਵਾਂ ਮਾਰੇ ਕਿਰਪਾ ਕਰੇ ਇਸ ਦਾ ਚੜ੍ਹਦੀਆਂ ਕਲਾ ਰੱਖਣ ਸਾਰੇ ਬੱਚਿਆਂ ਪਰਿਵਾਰਾਂ 'ਤੇ ਸੋ ਹੁਣ ਨਾਈਸਲੀ ਮੱਥਾ ਟੇਕ ਕੇ ਅਤੇ ਥੱਲੇ ਜਾਣਾ ਡੋਂਟ ਰਨ ਸੋ ਜਿਨ੍ਹਾਂ ਨੇ ਬਾਕੀ ਆਪਣੇ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਜਿੱਥੇ ਲੱਗਣਾ ਬਾਕੀ ਬੇਨਤੀ ਹੈ ਸਾਰੀ ਸੰਗਤ ਨੂੰ ਅੱਗੇ ਹੋ ਕੇ ਥੋੜ੍ਹਾ ਥੋੜ੍ਹਾ ਬਹਿ ਜਾਓ ਸਾਰੇ ਸਤਨਾਮ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ 'ਤੇ ਜਾਪ ਕਰਦੇ ਜਾਣਾ ਸਤਨਾਮ
ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕਾ ਖਾਲਸਾ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕੀ ਫਤਿਹ ਬਹੁਤ ਬਹੁਤ ਧੰਨਵਾਦ ਬੱਚਿਆਂ ਦਾ ਪੇਰੈਂਟਸ ਦਾ ਜਿਨ੍ਹਾਂ ਨੇ ਸਮਾਂ ਕੱਢ ਕੇ ਜੂ ਦਰਬਾਰ ਵਿੱਚ ਆਣ ਕੇ ਗੁਰੂ ਦੀਆਂ ਖੁਸ਼ੀਆਂ ਪ੍ਰਾਪਤ ਕੀਤੀਆਂ ਬਹੁਤ ਬਹੁਤ ਧੰਨਵਾਦ ਭਾਈ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਭਾਈ ਬਿਕਰਮਜੀਤ ਸਿੰਘ ਜੀ ਅਤੇ ਭੈਣ ਜੀ ਹੋਰਾਂ ਦਾ ਜਿਨ੍ਹਾਂ ਨੇ ਇਹ ਵਡਮੁੱਲੀ ਜਾਣਕਾਰੀ ਬੱਚਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਸਾਰੀ ਸਾਂਝੀ ਕੀਤੀ ਸੋ ਬਹੁਤ ਹੀ ਜ਼ਰੂਰਤ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਅਸੀਂ ਬੱਚਿਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਇੱਥੇ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਆਈਏ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਬੇਸਿਕ ਸਿੱਖ ਇਤਿਹਾਸ ਬਾਰੇ